Hi, this is Russ Anderson. The ViewShift system in Synthize lets you do removals and split take effects with Synthize, relying on a 3D track and geometry. You transfer pixels from one part of a shot to another, either within the same shot or from a different one. Usually the shots are of similar length, so retiming doesn't give the effect away. Sometimes, though, you may want to manually clean up a single frame using Photoshop or whatever and use that for the ViewShift. That fits perfectly within the standard ViewShift approach. Nothing special or different is required to work from a clean plate. Often, though, the clean plate is actually one of the frames from the existing shot, and in that case, Synthize can lend a hand to make the setup easier. At the end, I'll talk a little about what to do if the clean plate is not from the shot being worked on. For now, we're going to start with a version of the car removal shot we used in the first ViewShift tutorial. It's already solved and has the reflector mesh and animated spline. It also has a light that stores the average illumination level of this tracker down here in the middle of the road. You can also see the RGB curves in the graph editor. This is used for illumination compensation. Now, we could easily do a removal using this overall setup with the entire shot as the source, which is what we did in the first tutorial. But since this is a clean plate tutorial, I've already gone and cleaned up one of the frames to use as a clean plate. You could do that with Photoshop, but you can probably figure out the lazy approach that I used. I picked a frame near the end of the shot, frame 155. More about that later. We need to set up the source camera with the right location and field of view. We already have that information since we solved the entire shot, including for frame 155. So we're going to go to frame 155. Then on the ViewShift menu, we run the Prepare for Clean Plate script. It will do the following, all of which you could do yourself. It'll prompt you for the location of the clean plate. It will add it to your scene as a very short single frame shot. Then it'll copy the camera position, field of view, and distortion information from the current frame to the first frame of the new shot. You can see that as I scrub through the shot, on the first frame, it's positioned at the camera's position on frame 155 of the overall shot. The rest of the time, that camera doesn't have any position at all. The script will also make a copy of the illumination compensation light, bringing the illumination information from the current frame to the new shot's first frame also. It will adjust the view shift to set the source to the single frame camera too. So our output is set up. The other settings are at decent default settings. So we're ready to view shift. So now we're done. Let's play the result. At the end, you notice that the car becomes visible. That's because the clean plate doesn't contain replacement pixels for the very end of the scene. Basically, the car drove off the end of that image. So in fact, there's no single frame that can be used as a clean plate for the length of this shot. You know, that's a limitation of the clean plate technique. You need to have a clean plate that can contain all the needed pixels for the entire shot. Now, you might sometimes decide that you want to update the main camera track. If you do that, you'll want to update the clean plate's camera also. So let's take a look at the tracker errors in the graph editor. And you can see that there's some that are fairly high. So let's run cleanup trackers. We'll turn on bad frames and select a 2 pixel error as the threshold. Now we'll refine the solve. This doesn't make any dramatic changes in this particular case, but we still always want the clean plate to match up exactly. So we'll run the update clean plate script also. It'll update the camera position, field of view, and distortion information. It'll also update any illumination light. And it'll also, just as a convenience, it'll set the frame back to the clean plate frame, just as a reminder of which one that is. So at this point, you could rerun the view shift. Now, if your clean plate is not from the shot you're cleaning, you should add the clean plate with add shot. Then you'll need to set up the exact camera location and field of view. You might be able to get the field of view determined from the main shot, or you can get it as part of finding the camera position. So there are a variety of methods to do that, depending on what you have and know. The important point is that the coordinate system for the second shot must exactly match that of the first. So the main possibilities are to use the from seed points solving mode with some known XYZ positions. You can do that even though you're working just from a single frame. You look for common features in each of those shots, the original shot and the clean plate. Alternatively, you can use pin mesh in camera pinning mode. If you have some mesh that's inserted in the shot, you can use that as a basis to do your lineup. Or possibly you could use alignment lines as well, though that's not as accurate. So really the from seed points method is the best method because you do want accuracy. And of course, if the clean plate, you know, is really from the main shot, then you want to just go ahead and use the main solve and the prepare for clean plate script as the best choice. One final warning. When you do work from a single clean plate, there won't be noise in the inserted areas since they all come from the same single image. You may need to add matching noise into just the right areas. Normally, you'll write the output as a sequence with an alpha channel so you can composite over the shot yourself. You can use the alpha channel of the insert to control where the added noise goes in order to avoid giving the insert away. When you use the entire shot as a source, that's not an issue. Thanks for watching.